Good morning, first year BCom students. Now I'm going to make a presentation on the topic Final Accounts of Non-Trading Concerns, number 2. Final accounts of non-trading concerns consist of, you know, receipts and payments account, income and expenditure account, and the balance sheet. Now we'll begin with the receipts and payment account. Receipts and payments account is a summary of cash receipts and cash payments relating to a given period of time, usually a year. It is prepared on cash system of accounting. A non-trading concern maintains cash book, and in the cash book, the cash transactions are recorded in the order of dates. But at the end of the year, a summary of cash transactions will be prepared, cash receipts and cash payments, at the end of the accounting period, and that is nothing but receipts and payments account. It is prepared on cash system of accounting. That means there are two sides to the account, cash receipts and payment account. One is receipt side, the other one is payment side. Okay, it contains all cash receipts and cash payments of the current year, irrespective of the nature of the items, that is whether the items are capital or revenue. Revenue means recurring in nature, capital means they are non-recurring in nature. So whether the transactions are capital in nature or revenue in nature, irrespective of that, all cash receipts and cash payments will be recorded in cash book. Similarly, irrespective of the period to which the transactions relate to, the transaction might be relating to current year or previous year or next year, irrespective of that, as long as you have received the cash or as long as you have paid the cash, then the summary of that will be recorded in the receipts and payments account. The various items of cash receipts and cash payments recorded in the cash book are summarized and classified, that is grouped under suitable heads like subscriptions, donations, entrance fees, salaries, rent, electricity charges, etc., and are shown in the receipts and payments account. For example, subscriptions, donations, and entrance fees received on different dates are recorded on the receipt side of the cash book in the order of dates, in the chronological order. And then the total subscriptions received in the year, total donations received in the year, total entrance fees received in the year are shown on the receipt side of the receipts and payments account. Similarly, salary, rent, electricity charges paid on different dates are entered on the payment side of the cash book in the order of dates. And then the salaries paid during the year, total rent paid during the year, total electricity charges paid during the year are shown on the payment side of the receipts and payment account. So thus, summary of cash receipts and cash payments are recorded in the receipts and payment account, irrespective of whether the items are capital or revenue in nature, and whether the receipts and payments are relating to current year or next year or previous year. Thus, the receipts and payments account is a summary of the various items of cash receipts and cash payments extracted from the cash book for a particular year. Now, let us see some of the features of receipts and payments account. It's a real account. That means debit what comes in and credit what goes out. In other words, cash receipts are debited and cash payments are credited. It's prepared on cash system of accounting. Only cash transactions, summary of cash transactions are recorded in the receipts and payment account, and that is prepared from the cash book. Credit transactions are not recorded in the receipts and payments account. It's prepared at the end of the financial year or accounting year in the form of summary. It starts with opening cash and bank balances and ends with closing cash and bank balances. Receipts are shown on the debit side and payments are shown on the credit side of receipts and payments account. It includes receipts and payments of both capital and revenue items. It does not differentiate between capital items and revenue items. Everything, as long as they are in the form of cash receipts and cash payments, they are recorded. It includes all receipts and payments made during the accounting year, whether they are relate to the previous year, current year, or next year. As it is summary of actual cash receipts and cash payments, it does not include outstanding receipts and outstanding payments. Similarly, it does not include non-cash items like bad debts, depreciation, etc. It does not reveal the surplus or deficit. It shows merely the balance of cash in hand and cash in bank at the end of the accounting year. So, receipts and payments account, it's a basic account. Based on that, income and expenditure account and balance sheets are being prepared. Now, let us see what is an income and expenditure account. So, receipts and payments account, as you already learned, does not disclose or reveal the surplus or deficit. Therefore, in order to ascertain the surplus or deficit, non-trading concerns are required to prepare another account called income and expenditure account. Income and expenditure account is a revenue account of non-trading concern. It is similar to the profit and loss account of trading concerns. It is a summary of incomes and expenses for a particular period, usually a year. It serves the same purpose as the profit and loss account in trading concern. It's prepared on accrual system of accounting. That means all the incomes and all the expenses of the accounting year, whether they have received or not, and whether they have paid or not, as long as they are incurred or accrued, they will be taken into account. 12 months income and 12 months expenses are going to be taken. If some of the incomes are outstanding, they are taken care of. If expenses are either outstanding or paid in advance, they are adjusted. So 12 months incomes and 12 months expenses are considered under income and expenditure account. Let us see the features of income and expenditure account. It's a nominal account. Debit the expenses and losses and credit the incomes and gains. So expenses are debited and expenses and losses are debited. Incomes and gains are credited to the income and expenditure account. It is prepared from the receipts and payment account and the relevant information. Like for example, outstanding information on outstanding incomes, outstanding expenses, prepaid expenses, pre-received incomes, depreciation, like that. So, receipts and payments account will be considered. Further, additional information will be taken in order to prepare income and expenditure account. It is prepared at the end of an accounting year. And it is prepared on the accrual system of accounting. I already told you, it takes into account the total incomes earned during the year, whether received or not, and total expenses incurred during the year, whether paid or not. It is prepared on the same lines as that of profit and loss account of a trading concern. All incomes are shown on the credit side, and all expenses are shown on the debit side of income and expenditure account. It includes only revenue receipts and revenue payments. In other words, capital receipts and capital payments will not be entered in the income and expenditure account. Rather, they will be taken while preparing the balance sheet. So, only revenue receipts and revenue payments are taken. It includes only revenue receipts and revenue payments of only the current year. It does not include revenue receipts and revenue payments of previous year or next year. It is considering revenue receipts and revenue payments of only current year because it is prepared on accrual basis. It includes outstanding incomes and outstanding expenses also. So, we'll consider outstanding incomes and outstanding expenses while preparing income and expenditure account. Even prepaid and pre-received incomes are considered while preparing income and expenditure account. It also includes non-cash items such as bad debts, depreciation, etc. because these are also essential part of the total expenses and incomes of the income, non-trading concern. The closing balance of this account shows excess of income over expenditure. We call that surplus. If the total of incomes is more than expenditure, then that is surplus. Or excess of expenditure over income, that is deficit. Sometimes expenditure might be more than the incomes. So in that case, there is shortage or deficit. The credit side exceeds the debit side. The balance is called excess of income over expenditure or surplus. On the other hand, if the debit side exceeds the credit side, the balance is called excess of expenditure or income or deficit. So that's all about receipts and payments account and income and expenditure account. In the next video, we are going to learn about balance sheet and other related items. Thank you.